Hey guys, welcome back to AutoTechNick. Today, real quick video, we're gonna go ahead and talk about the right way to inspect your oil filter for any debris or metal. I see a lot of you guys do it really close to the right way. There's one little extra thing you need to do. We're gonna talk about that right now. Before we jump into it, I just wanted to take a minute and point out the irony. Here I am out in the shop, just wanted to work on my own car, whip out a quick oil change so I can have it ready to go for the summer. And yep, on working on jack stands and ramps on the ground, and that's because the boat's still occupied in the lift. Now, after spending 20 years working on cars daily, I always fantasized and dreamed about having my own shop with a lift. Now I actually have it, but I'm back to still working on ramps and jack stands. It just seems that you can't get away from it. I just can't help but laugh at the irony of it all. All right, fortunately for me on this oil filter, I don't have to worry about removing the metal canister from it. On this application, it's just the paper element that goes into the insert. But on the cases where you do have the metal canister, you can go ahead and cut those off. Now they make tools to cut those off. You can use a pair of tin snips. I shy away from using anything abrasive because I don't want to create any sparks or small metal to give us a false reading while we're looking at the filter. Now, we all know you cut the filters open, you move the pleats, and you take a peek and look for metal, but there's one more step to go further that's gonna give you a much better idea, and that's what we're here to talk about. In order to do this, is what we need to do is take a section of this filter and these pleats and rip it open, rip it apart, and get it free from the rest of the filter. Okay, so I got a section of the oil filter removed, just went ahead and tore it out, and I'll get a close-up here so you can see it, and we can see a few indications. Nothing major. I don't expect anything major because this is just a routine oil change. But the trick is this paper is actually saturated with oil. We need to get that oil out to get a much better view. So you just go ahead and take the oil filter, wrap it up in a paper towel, and just squeeze it in a bench vise. And we're just going to go ahead and squeeze all that oil out of the filter and get into the towel, and it lets us see it much, much better. Now this is a trick that I actually got taught by one of my dad's old drag racing friends when I was 17 years old. And truth be told, I spent 20 years in the automotive industry. I worked in multiple shops with hundreds of technicians. Never once did I ever see this trick again. Only that one time I got shown this trick. It's hung with me ever since, and it has helped quite a bit. So you can see we got it all squeezed out, and you can see that the paper towel is pretty saturated. There we go. And now you can have a much better view of what's actually in there and how much metal you have or don't have. So it's a pretty quick, easy trick. Now, unfortunately, I don't have, or fortunately, I don't have an example with a failed engine where there's a lot of metal in there. I do have a little speckles here, which does not worry me in this case, but I hope I don't have to come back and show you guys what one looks like on an engine failure, but it's very, very obvious. Or if you're really fighting one small thing on an engine, this really helps you narrow it down and pinpoint it. Try this on your own. Jump in the comments. Let me know what you think of this method. And guys, I hope I gave you another tip. Like I said, this one's hung around with me forever. I haven't seen it enough. Quick, easy, simple. We should all be doing it. Just go a little bit further when you're checking your filter. As always, guys, thank you for taking the time to watch the video. We'll see you on the next one.